Hello guys, and welcome back to another video from my YouTube channel, that is Vipin Sharma Biology Tutorials. And in today's video we are going to talk about the molecular diagnosis of different kind of disease with the help of biotechnology. So how we can utilize our knowledge of biotechnology to diagnose different kind of disease. Okay, this is quite important. So kaise pata laga sakte hain different kind of disease ka with the help of biotechnology. Okay, so when we want to treat any kind of disease, what is the basic requirement? The basic requirement to treat any disease is its early diagnosis. Because when we can diagnose a particular disease in early stage, then the chances of survival of the individual increases. Okay, therefore it is quite important ki hum har disease ko bahut hi jaldi pata laga paye, so that we can treat it easily and we can easily understand the pathophysiology. Okay, what do you mean by pathophysiology? It means that the physiology of pathogen. Okay, the pathogen that is causing different kind of disease in organisms, if we are able to understand its physiology, its basic reactions and how it is influencing our physiological reactions, toh hum aasani se pata laga sakte hain ki kahan par usne gadbad paida ki hai hamari body mein. And then we can easily eradicate that particular pathogen. We can easily treat that particular disease with the help of early diagnosis. This is quite important. Okay, so there are some conventional methods jo ki har doctor apnata hai. All the doctors do some conventional tests such as serum test and urine analysis, but these things are not very much responsible to diagnose a particular disease early. If we will talk about genetic disorder, then we cannot find up the genetic disorder from these two tests. Okay, we cannot diagnose them early. Hum in diseases ke bare mein kabhi pata hi nahi laga payenge bahut zyada jaldi if we will do the conventional tests such as serum analysis and urine analysis. Therefore, we have utilized some techniques of biotechnology for the early diagnosis of various kind of disease so that we can easily treat them. For example, the recombinant DNA technology. We are reading about the recombinant DNA technology from very long lectures, and we know very well about the mechanism of recombinant DNA technology. We have already taken into consideration PCR, that is polymerase chain reaction. We have talked about the mechanism of PCR. If you have not watched that to the playlist, you can check it out. And the third most important test of biotechnology is ELISA. ELISA simply means enzyme linked immunosorbent assay. So the enzyme linked immunosorbent assay or the ELISA test is very much useful to diagnose AIDS. Okay, so many kind of disease can be easily diagnosed in early stage with the help of biotechnological tests such as recombinant DNA technology, polymerase chain reaction and enzyme linked immunosorbent assay. Okay, so the pathogen is suspected usually with the help of symptoms. Okay, jab for example this is a pathogen, it is creating some symptoms in human beings. Okay, this is human. Okay, so it is creating some symptoms such as abdominal pain or different kind of symptoms, then we can easily suspect that pathogen ki haan kuch to gadbad hai, there is some kind of mishappening, it means that there is some pathogen, then we can diagnose that particular disease. But when a particular pathogen shows symptom at that particular time, there is very high concentration of that pathogen. Okay, so we can easily find out a pathogen with the help of symptoms, but at the particular time of symptom, the concentration of that pathogen is quite high, so it becomes quite difficult to correct that particular disease at that time. Therefore, the early diagnosis is quite necessary so that at that time, concentration of pathogen is quite less, so we can easily treat that disease. Okay, so we have to treat a particular disease when the pathogen is present in low concentration, and we can diagnose some disease without even taking symptoms into consideration. Bina symptom ke paida hue bhi hum kafi disease ka pata laga sakte hain jab pathogen kafi low concentration mein hai. How? We can use different kind of tricks which are present in biotechnology such as PCR. PCR mein humne kya padha tha, that is used to amplify the nucleic acid content. Okay, so if we will amplify the nucleic acid content of a particular pathogen, then we can easily understand ki pathogen present hai body mein. Okay, for example, this is the pathogen's nucleic acid, but now it is amplified. So we can easily take a look on the nucleic acid. We can easily find out whether some pathogen is present in our body or not when it is in low concentration. This is in low concentration, but we can amplify it to look whether some pathogen is present or not by the help of PCR. So these kind of biotechnological technologies are quite important to understand the disease, okay, so that we can easily treat them. और इसी तरीके से काफ़ी सारी disease causing जो pathogen है उनको हम पता लगा सकते हैं with the help of biotechnology. So हम क्या करते हैं, PCR को use करते हैं to identify the suspected pathogen of HIV, जो कि काफ़ी बार present होता है but it does not show any kind of symptoms. So to identify that we need to use PCR. It can be used to detect different kind of mutations in genes as well as in cancerous cell. Cancerous cells में काफ़ी बार mutations हो जाती हैं. To understand, to identify those mutations in cancerous cell, we can use PCR technique. Okay? As well as many genetic disorders can also be taken into consideration and can be easily detected with the help of PCR. So PCR is quite important because it amplify the nucleic acid content. The nucleic acid content is amplified with the help of PCR. That's why we can easily look the pathogen and we can easily identify whether the pathogen is present or not. And if it is present, then the disease can be treated with the help of early diagnosis. Okay, so the PCR is very helpful in identifying HIV mutations and mutations in cancerous cell as well as some genetic disorders. So there are some techniques to identify the mutation. Now we are going to take into consideration that particular technique. There are some single-stranded DNA or single-stranded RNA molecules which are tagged with radioactive molecules. Okay, for example, this is a single-stranded DNA, or we can say that this is a single-stranded RNA. In single-stranded RNA mein, there are many molecules. Okay, there is nucleic acid, so obviously we are having phosphate, we are having nitrogen, we are having oxygen, and different kind of elements were there. Okay, so we can tag those elements with their radioactive isotope. Okay, un particular cheezon ko hum kehte hain probe. So this particular single stranded DNA or RNA which is synthesized so that its elements contains radioactive isotope, inhe hum kehte hain probe. These are known as probe, and these probes will help us to identify different kind of mutations. Okay, how to create a probe? We have single stranded DNA or RNA. It has a lot of elements as well as a lot of bases, nitrogenous bases. So we need to tag their elements, any one of element, with radio that it is dissimilar from the normal isotope. Okay, for example, hum nitrogen 15 use kar rahe hain, that is obviously different from nitrogen 14. Okay, the nitrogen 15 isotope, which is a little bit heavy, it is quite different from the N14 isotope. Aise hi karke hum kafi sare radioactive isotopes le sakte hain. Okay, so we can use different kind of radio isotope, not heavy isotopes all the time, but radioactive isotopes. There is a lot of difference between heavy isotope and radioactive isotope. Okay, that's quite important. So प्रोब क्या करेंगे, प्रोब को हम अलाउ करेंगे टू हाइब्रिडाइज विद इट्स कॉम्प्लीमेंट्री सीक्वेंस. वी नो द सीक्वेंस ऑफ अ डीएनए वेरी वेल. ओके, व्हेन वी नो द सीक्वेंस ऑफ डीएनए वेरी वेल, देन वी सिंथेसाइज प्रोब्स कॉम्प्लीमेंट्री टू इट. ओके, दीज कॉम्प्लीमेंट्री प्रोब्स विल बाइंड टू द डीएनए सीक्वेंसेस. लेकिन अगर डीएनए में म्यूटेशन है, इफ म्यूटेशन इज प्रेजेंट इन डीएनए, देन द कॉम्प्लीमेंट्री प्रोब विल नॉट बाइंड टू दैट पर्टिकुलर सिक्वेंस बिकॉज नाउ ड्यू टू म्यूटेशन इट हैज लॉस्ट इट्स कॉम्प्लीमेंटेरिटी. यहां पर जाहिर सी बात है, अगर म्यूटेशन हो गई है, इसका मतलब यहां पर कोई बेस चेंज हुआ है, और बेस चेंज हुआ है तो प्रोब के जो बेसिस हैं जो इसके जस्ट कॉम्प्लीमेंट्री थे, वो अब बाइंड नहीं करेंगे क्योंकि बेस तो चेंज हो चुका ड्यू टू म्यूटेशन. दैट्स वाई हम म्यूटेशन का पता लगा सकते हैं, एक जो प्रोब है वो बाइंड नहीं करेगा. दिस इज क्वाइट इंपॉर्टेंट. ओके, सो there are a lot of things in that, let's check it out. So the probe is allowed to hybridize or to pair with the complementary sequence in cells. Okay, so they are detected by using autoradiography. In autoradiography there is a plate that is known as photographic plate. In that photographic film sare ke sare jo paired sequences hain wo dikh jate hain. All the paired sequences will be shown. For example, all these got paired, but this does not got paired due to mutation. So this will not be shown in the photographic plate, and all of these are shown in the photographic plate. So there is a lot of difference. Okay, we are going to look that particular difference now. So let's talk about this. This is DNA, this is double stranded DNA, and we know the sequence of this double stranded DNA. After knowing the sequence, we have synthesized the single-stranded probes for it. These are radioactive. Okay, these are radioactive isotope containing single-stranded probes, which can bind to this particular complementary sequence. Now we have hybridized them. हमने इन्हें मौका दे दिया कि जाओ बाइंड कर लो. Now this red ones are the DNA sequences. This black one is the probe. This red one is the DNA sequences. This is again the probe. So both of these are complementary to each other. It means that there is no mutation. This will be shown in the photographic plate. This is also paired because no mutation is occurring there. This is also present in the photographic plate. This is also present in the photographic plate. This is also paired. But in this case, we have a mutation. That's why this gene is shown with green color. This is mutated. This is mutated. And since this is mutated, then there is no probe which is binding to this particular site. There is no probe that is binding to the green color's site. And if there is no probe binding, it will not be present in the photographic plate. Therefore, we can identify that this particular gene is having mutation. That's how we can find out the mutation. Okay, now let's talk about ELISA. It is enzyme linked immunosorbent assay, which is a very great technique to identify the HIV. Okay, it is based on the antigen antibody interaction. Whenever some foreign particle enters our body, it has some antigens on it. Okay, for example, this is a cell, it will have antigens on it, on its surface. Okay, and there are some antibodies. Humne padhi hai in immunology that there are some antibodies, Y-shaped antibodies, which are synthesized, and this particular antibodies show response to these antigens. Okay, and they eradicate them. So since there is an interaction between antigens and antibodies, these are the antibodies, Y-shaped antibodies, these will interact with these antigens which are present on cell. These antigens may be proteins and glycoproteins, means it is the binding of protein with different kind of sugars. So proteins or glycoproteins which are present on the infective agent are antigens, and there are some antibodies which are synthesized in our body in response to that pathogen. So when we detect either antibody in our body or the antigens, then we can easily find out that there is some problem, there is some pathogen. Because if antigens are present, it means that there is some pathogen. And if antibodies are present, it means that there is some pathogen jiski liye ye antibody tayar ki gayi hai. So that's how we can diagnose different kind of things with the help of biotechnology. I hope you understood this lecture. Agar aapko ye lecture samajh mein aaya, then please do hit like button. And if you are watching my video for the very first time and you found it beneficial, then please subscribe to my YouTube channel, that is Vipin Sharma Biology Tutorials, and share this video among your friends. Thank you so much, and stay tuned for the upcoming videos on applications of biotechnology.